Hello once again, welcome to this RHCSA program version 8. Here I will be discussing about how to reset the password and also basic networking or how to assign IP address and of course the domain name, system name, host name, etc. So the most important thing which I wanted to update you is that you should know how to reset the root password. In the examination, the password will be given to you and the existing password will not be given at all, I believe you. If you fail to reset the password, your entire question paper is gone. So I would suggest you to basically go ahead and practice a couple of times, two or three times. Okay, so let us move ahead in resetting the password. So here I just paused the server after a boot. You need to pause within less than 5 seconds. So once you pause this particular one, you can basically press E to edit, E for edit, E. Like once you press E, you'll be going into a script. So here go to Linux, go to the end of the line, and say, write this word rd.break console equal to tty1. I repeat once again, rd.break at the end of the line space console equal to tty1. Once after this is done, press control x. The instruction is given at the bottom also. You can go through that control x. So just wait for about a minute, around 5-10 seconds. So that it will go ahead in putting in a quiet mode and not in a recovery mode. We call this as a recovery mode. So that a single user, mode will come. You are okay. So you are now in the hash prompt. So what you need to do now is basically mount the system in read write mode. Presently it is mounted in read only mode. Mount -o remount comma rw slash sysroot. Again I repeat, mount -o remount comma read write slash sysroot. It returns with the hash prompt, but now it has mounted in read write. chroot, change the ownership to root, sysroot, because this is mounted on memory. Okay, now you got this hash prompt. So here now you can see, ls -l, you can see all the files which are there. Okay, now I need to change the password tsswd for root. It is very simple, tsswd root. So now I am setting the new password, whatever it doesn't ask for the old password. So I am changing the password to a newer one which is supplied. Okay, it has been set. Now touch slash dot auto relabel. Okay, done. So now almost all the process is done. Give an exit, one more exit. So to continue your boot process, log out. Okay, so it will reboot normally. It will take a minute's time to complete the boot process. But now this time you will be using the new password which has been set. Okay, this hardly takes about 3 to 4 minutes, but it's mandatory. So you see this percentage is coming across, let it go through. It goes through all the percentages. Once this is done, the system booting continues. I'm just pausing. So it goes for a normal boot. Now, reboot. Okay, so now I am logging in with the root with the new password. I mean, which has been set. Okay, I'm just signing in. Okay, so you can see here, I can log into this computer system terminal. The new passcode which has been set. With this, we have completed how to reset root passcode. Now I'll tell you about how to basically assign IP address and host name, etc., to the system. So earlier, the IP address which may be if it is there or not, how will we check is you have a command called as ifconfig. So here you'll be knowing about the IP address which has been given is 192.168.1.21. Okay, now how to change this particular IP? How to change? You have a tool called as nmtui. Okay, so nmtui. We have a command along with this which is called as nmcli, that is command line mode. It's a bit, memory oriented. You need to practice a little bit, but this is one of the easiest way for RSCSA. You can use this tool for RSCA. You can use this CLI. Okay, so I'll quickly go ahead with this NMCLI. So here you can see this. First of all, if you want to see change anything, ENS33 is your interface name. You can say edit. So by default, you can see it's automatic. Don't change the above two parameters, otherwise the complete thing will change. Even here also you can only see show, but don't change anything, don't clone anything. Okay, but here IPv4 address, change this automatic to manual. So this IP address will be provided in your exam, so we need to configure. I will configure now 192.168. Here in this case I'll give something like 25. Okay, and maybe like I can say /24 is my subnet mask, and gateway 192.168.1.1, and my DNS is add 192.168.1.1, or maybe I can add one more DNS, secondary DNS 8888. Okay, search DNS if you want, you can. If it is given in the exam, you can. So now the other parameters, like nothing required. Require IPv4 for this connection, select that with spacebar, and now automatically connect. All these things should be enabled here, automatically connect and available to all users, and say okay. So go back, and now what you can do, you can even set the host name. See, once you set this host name, server B, it will be given in the system in the name which you want to set. Once you make changes, you need to make a reboot also. So for this, in order to make changes for the IP address, please deactivate this first time and activate once again, so that the service is restarted back. And now quit. So now you can see ifconfig with the new IP address which you have set, which is 1.25. How can we test this particular one? With help of ping 192.168.1.25. Yes, fantastic, congratulations, you have done it basically. So this activity, like even you can test whether you are able to ping the gateway 192.168.1.1. Yes, perfectly working. So with this, I think we have done the basic things. So password reset, IP addressing, once you do all these things, you can configure your YUM, you can enable your, SE Linux, etc., all these things, and start writing your exam, because these are the preliminary things which you need to do before attempting. Okay, I hope everything is clear. Thank you.